please welcome the Spice Girls. Woo!
It's a beautiful place to be. It's nice and hot.
Very hot and humid.
I learned from Brazil last night, Obrigado.
Obrigado.
Okay, just a few more photos and then please put your cameras away. Another few seconds.
Fare fotometna, si lupe. No sacamos las fotos ahora, por favor. So where are you all from then?
Argentina.
Argentina.
What did you think about the forest and the river?
Oh, we thought it was really peaceful. Last night we were lucky enough to go for a little sail out and it was really peaceful, it was lovely.
Yeah, we stayed on a boat on the river, so it was good fun.
Yeah, and we were totally doing Sting. You know Sting, the artist, the cause, you know, about cutting down the rainforest. So we really stand behind that.
We also saw the two rivers that meet. The two rivers that meet.
What's that called?
The meeting of
the meeting of
two rivers. We saw it.
But the sea meets the river.
Yep.
And the piranhas.
And the dolphins.
I'm from Radio Rock and Pop of Chile.
Yeah.
And now I'm talking in Spanish because it's my language. ¿Cuál es la idea de venir a un lugar como Manaus a hacer el lanzamiento del Spice World a Sudamérica?
Oh, why the idea of coming to the Amazon?
These are exactly.
I think, you know, our new album, Spice World, you know, we've been, you know, been to many places. It's kind of like a whistle stop tour of the world.
Whistle stop tour of the world.
No, I think
that's a big camera.
We're all really big fans of South America. It's like one of our favourite places.
And we're here because of the competition winners.
That's what
we wanted to meet our fans.
And we just think, you know, what better place than the Amazon? I mean, it's somewhere we all wanted to visit, so what a great excuse to go there.
And we thought we'd bring you all with us.
Do you not like Brazil? What do you think? You know, you're glad that
it's beautiful, isn't it? Very beautiful.
Good. Yeah. So how long have you been here? You arrived on Saturday, didn't you?
Monday.
On Monday.
Wow.
It's a good holiday, isn't it?
Could you tell me the little
bonus is that you get to meet us a lot.
Which of one could you tell about your early influences? What kind of music did you used to hear in your childhood and teenage years?
I was a big fan when I was growing up of Nina Cherry. She was like one of the people that I really used to look up to. I used to dress like her and like learn all her words to her song. She was like quite an important female role model in my life.
Nice.
I loved pop music always, you know, Madonna and Wham. But then again, I like Frank Sinatra and Elvis and ABBA.
I was brought up with a lot of Motown music. I like strong melodies. I'm a massive pop fan, and I like all different kinds of music. I think if you're musical, you like any music, appreciate anything.
I like a lot of soul music. I'm a big fan of Anita Baker, Toni Braxton, Maxwell, that kind of music. Something with a lot of soul, that's what I like.
Soul.
Yeah, I think, you know, it should be great because we've all got really different influences. I mean, I was brought up also like Emma, but like Motown. Stevie Wonder's like my favourite artist of all time. Then I love Madonna. And like I really like rock music as well. But I think, you know, a great thing about the Spice Girls is because our taste is so diverse, it comes together really well on both of our albums and all the music that we write.
It helps us write.
Who's Opera House is beautiful, isn't it?
It is.
It's really nice.
Yeah. Makes me want to sing Nest in the Dawn or whatever it's called.
Apparently, someone was saying that this is Pavarotti's favourite place to sing. Is it? Yeah.
Hi, girls.
Hi.
I come from Santiago de Chile.
Chile.
De Grama. Ahora en español. Les quiero preguntar cuál es la mayor diferencia entre el primer disco Spice y el segundo Spice World y por qué en el último decidieron incluir algunos ritmos latinos, como en el primer single.
He wants to know what's the difference between the first and the second album, and why did you put in the third album some Latin rhythm?
I think love with With the second album, before we wrote that, we travelled a lot of the world, picked up different cultures, learned a lot about different sort of music. And when we came back from Acapulco, we actually wrote Spice Up Your Life, which has got that Latino feel. We've also got a beautiful Spanish guitar in one of our songs. And we do everything that we dream of. Like, we tried out a Motown track, we tried out a big band song that Joey enjoys. And also, with the first album, we wrote that quite a long time ago, but with this new album, it's quite new and everything.
It's very current.
Yeah, it's very current.
But the Latin feel, I think, is we like that.
I'm Susana, Argentina, Radio Uno. Jerry, do you speak Spanish?
Sí, pero solo un poco. Sí, tú hablas muy
despacio. Las fanáticas de las Spice Girls quieren escuchar algo en español de parte tuya.
¿Quieres hear me speak what in Spanish?
Sorry, speak very little.
Yeah.
Do you Spanish?
Yeah, I speak a little bit.
Yes. Can you please speak something in Spanish for your Spanish fans?
Okay, what do you want me to say? Hola, muchos besos de las chicas picantes. Me gusta mucho. Me gusta mucho.
And I can say, una cerveza, por favor.
Una cerveza. Un poco caliente. Un barito caliente.
I am Angelica. I come from Chile, Más Música. The music program. And how is your relation with other artists? Do you have friends?
Yeah, we do, but I think that whenever we do like big shows and stuff like that, we have fun between like the five of us. But we do have like a few celebrity friends, but we're more like, we kind of like stick together in that kind of area.
Yeah, it's quite nice, you know, sometimes on the road you do bump into other artists, but it's always very brief, you know, passing backstage. But it's funny because a lot of people ask about competition with other acts, and we don't feel competition with anybody because everybody's just doing their own thing and there's room for everybody. Do you know what I mean? So it's really nice.
Yeah, everybody's really friendly, I think, because also, you know, we all know what we have to do and
what we're going
to. Yeah, it's quite nice to speak to other people that know. And we're all, you know, it's all quite friendly. It's no competition at all.
I don't think you're sort of seeing us like celebrities. You sort of just see us people in the same job.
Yeah.
Debido a la cantidad de fanáticos que tienen en Sudamérica y en todo el mundo, en especial para la gente de Chile, la posibilidad de una gira sudamericana de tocar en vivo su música.
Yo lo he comprendido, usted ha hablado muy deprisa, por favor.
La posibilidad de una gira por Sudamérica y tocar en Chile.
Ah, eso es muy bueno. They want to know what's the possibility of going around South America, especially Chile. with a show or
whatever. Well, I mean, as I've said, we really are big fans of South America, and we've got a lot of dates set up for our tour, but you know, we haven't finalised everything yet, so I mean, hopefully South America will be on the cards too. Especially Chile.
Hey! Way!
Thank you, Spice Girls!
Thank you!
En este momento me encuentro afuera del Teatro Amazonas, que es más o menos el teatro municipal de nosotros, ¿no? Ellas en un segundito más, me refiero a Spice Girls, van a aparecer por este balcón, es por eso que ustedes ven tanta cantidad de público, la verdad es que jóvenes, niños, adultos, todos con sus cámaras que están ahí alertas a poder estar, aunque sea un minutito, con Spice Girls. Ellas en este teatro dieron su conferencia de prensa donde se mostraron muy, muy simpáticas y también yo tuve la posibilidad, junto a algunos ganadores de los diferentes países, de conversar con ellas y de entregarles las cartas que ustedes me enviaron, que la verdad eran una bolsa gigante, pero ellas estaban felices, recibieron la bolsa con las cartas y seguro que las van a leer. Así es que estaban muy contentas y le mandaron un beso gigante. No les puedo mostrar las imágenes porque no podíamos entrar las cámaras, pero sí les prometo que las cartas están en las manos de Spice Girls.
Yeah! bueno, de lo bueno poco. En lo personal se me pasó volando y creo que eso es porque estuvo muy bueno el programa, estuvo entretenido. Primero que nada, nos fuimos a almorzar con las chicas de Spice Girls, estuvimos con ellas en la piscina. La verdad, muy simpáticas, ellas se acercaron a cada una de las mesas de los diferentes países. Pudimos conversar de lo que quisiéramos, ahí le hacíamos preguntas, todas, pero muy buena onda. El único problema es que no podíamos entrar cámaras de televisión porque ellas tienen muy, muy cuidada su imagen. Pero luego de Londres nos van a enviar las imágenes que tomaron ahí mientras estábamos conversando con ellas. Así que apenas las tengamos aquí en Canal 13, les prometo que en Más Música se las vamos a mostrar. Luego nos fuimos a una playa maravillosa que estaba rodeada así en llamas. De repente llegaron unas canoas, unos indios, y nos enseñaron a bailar todos unos bailes absolutamente indígenas del Amazonas propiamente tal, ¿no? Y esta coronita que tengo hecha yo me la hizo nada menos que una de las personas que manejaba la canoa. Y me dijo, tú eres mi princesa y por eso me entregó esta coronita. Así que yo me la llevo a Santiago y ya es re tarde, es bastante tarde. Lo único que quiero sí es darle un beso gigante. Como este programa llega a toda América, todos los amigos que nos acompañaron desde Suiza, Argentina, Estados Unidos, Canadá, París. La verdad es que, bueno, ustedes saben, 12 países estuvieron durante todo este tour, esta aventura en el Amazonas con nosotros, se portaron increíblemente bien con Chile. Así es que nos vemos este otro domingo, 3:15, y espero que les haya gustado mucho este programa. Un beso gigante nuevamente. Chao.